Dozens of Philippine firms make it to a list of the top 500 firms in the region. Fortune Magazine's inaugural Southeast Asia 500 showed San Miguel Corporation as the sole Filipino company in the top 10. It was followed by the C family's SM Investments and the MVP Group's Meralco. Most of the local firms in the ranking are conglomerates of some of the country's richest families. They include JG Summit of the Gokongways, as well as the Ayala, Aboy Thiz, and Lucio Tan groups. ABS-CBN Corporation's parent firm, Lopez Holdings, is also on the list at the 18th spot. Fortune's top 500 list is mainly based on companies' revenues. Energy companies were the top three in the list, namely Singapore's Trafigura Group, as well as PTT and Pertamina of Indonesia. The Marcos administration unveiled today the new guidelines to accelerate its infrastructure drive. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines now on the line for the details. Hi, Andy.
Hi, Denise. The Philippine government has formally launched the implementing guidelines for Executive Order 59, which aims to streamline the licensing and permitting process or cut the red tape in key infrastructure projects. The EO was signed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. last April 30 in a bid to accelerate the government's infrastructure drive. Anti-Red Tape Authority Director General Ernesto Perez discussed some of its salient features this morning. He said that before the release of the EO, the permitting process for infrastructure flagship projects was very complicated and involved around 30 different issuing agencies. Now, applicants will only have to go through 12 to 18 agencies. The processing timeline has also been reduced to 3 days for simple projects, 7 days for complex projects, and 20 days for highly technical projects. If they fail to comply with this prescribed time frame, then the application is deemed approved. National Economic Development Authority Undersecretary Joseph Capuno also pointed out that applicants may submit their documents for approval simultaneously to these different agencies, whereas before, it was a sequential or step-by-step kind of process. He added that the enforcement of the measure will particularly benefit about 35 to 50 infrastructure projects that are currently in the pre-project implementation stage. These are mostly physical connectivity projects being led by the Transportation and Public Works Departments, as well as irrigation projects under the Agriculture Department. Both agencies hope that the proper implementation of EO number 59 will help raise the Philippines' ranking in the IMD Competitive Index. The 2024 report again placed the Philippines in the 13th spot out of 14 economies in Asia, citing infrastructure development as one of the key challenges the country is facing. And meanwhile, apart from delays in the licensing and permitting process, the NEDA pointed out that the need to also look into how to address the right-of-way issues that also hamper the completion of infrastructure projects, particularly the challenge of securing enough funds to resolve these right-of-way issues. Denise?
Thanks for that, Andy.
Other countries also rallying behind the Philippines over the South China Sea issue. Britain's ambassador to the Philippines condemns the dangerous actions of Chinese vessels. The UK now reiterating its call for China to adhere to the UNCLOS for all its maritime activities. The French embassy also expressing serious concern over China's latest aggression. It stressed the importance of resolving disputes through a dialogue. New Zealand called China's actions escalatory and dangerous, adding they threaten the lives and safety of maritime personnel. South Korea also reiterating the importance of upholding peace, stability, and rules-based maritime order in the South China Sea. And finally, Australia calls China's actions in Second Thomas Shoal illegal as they endanger lives and regional stability.